Dear students, good morning. Yesterday we had a discussion on meaning of beta ray spectrum, which means we know that beta ray spectrum means only atomic number changes but mass number remains constant. See, there are three types of beta decay. One is negatron emission, which means negative charge particle, which one? That is electron. Then positron emission, that is beta plus decay. Here positron means positive charge, that is positron. Then third one is orbital electron capture, or it is also known as k capture. First we move on to positron emission, or it is, see, there are two charge particles, one is negative, another one is positive. Here beta plus means positive charge only, beta minus means negative charge. See, when the nucleus, see, consider this as parent nucleus, that is AXZ, it undergo interaction with the neutrons, that is, we know that A tends to B, B tends to C. A is a parent nucleide, undergo disintegration with daughter nucleide which gives stable end product C. See, here with the emission of C, it undergo C, AXZ is a parent nucleide, it undergo daughter nucleide B. Here see, mass number remains constant but it is changes by atomic number, that is Z. Then it undergo beta plus emission, which gives beta plus particle, that is positive charge with the emission of neutrino. See, this is the how positron decay takes place. For example, consider carbon 11, which gives boron, that is 11. From this case, see, here AXZ, which gives AXZ minus 1 plus positive charge, that is electron. It is opposite of electron. See, consider carbon 11, 6, it undergo beta plus decay. Here positron means beta plus decay, which gives boron 11 with the emission of electron. Consider carbon 11, 6, it undergo beta plus, that is positive charge, it undergo boron 11, 5. Finally, it gives plus 1. See, this is the decay of positron. When boron, the stable end product is boron plus positive charge particle, that is positron. In beta plus decay, a proton is converted into neutron with the emission of positron. But a free proton does not undergo this type of decay. Then beta plus decay discovered later than beta minus decay. Since all naturally occurring radioactive nuclides have excess of neutrons, the mode of beta plus decay is complementary to the mode of beta minus decay. See, from next one is, see, this is the another example. See, magnesium 23-12, it undergo decay which gives sodium 23 with the emission of positron. Similarly, see, this is positron annihilation. We know that annihilation means mass is Ca, it converted into electromagnetic radiations of energy. Here there are two possibilities. See, one is here charge is different, but mass of both electron and positron are remains same. See, electron having mass 511 keV and positron also having 511 keV. It undergo annihilation or it undergo collision, it undergo interaction which gives with the emission of photons, their total energy is 1.02 MeV. Total energy 511 plus 511, that is 1.02 MeV, convert into mega electron volt. This is positron annihilation, when electron and positron having same mass but opposite charges, but it differs in charges and their mass is, that is converted into electromagnetic radiations of energy, that is photons, which converted into photons, light photons. See, that is positron annihilation. It is reverse process of another one is pair production. Next class I will discuss that is interaction of gamma rays with matter. One is photoelectric effect, Compton effect and pair production. Here positron means which undergo decay with parent nucleide which gives daughter nucleide stable end product, and finally you get positive charge particle, that is positron.